A very important study from the Institute of Medicine of the National Academies was released in December of 2011. This important study was funded by the Susan G. Komen Foundation for the Cure. We don't know what causes breast cancer, and there has been an overriding concern by many groups that perhaps there are specific things in our environment that are increasing the rate of breast cancer that we see in the United States and other Western-like countries. Factors like air quality, factors like hairsprays, deodorants, I mean just a variety of things, plastics that we have and things that we consume, etc., etc. And so I've got in my hand here an overview of the IOM, that's the Institute of Medicine's report about environmental links. And the bottom line of the study is a couple different things. First of all, there's a lifelong exposure potentially to the risk of developing breast cancer. And so we cannot forget that when adolescent girls are developing their breasts, that those breasts are potentially at risk for factors like cigarette smoking, as an example. That we do know that cigarette smoking is a risk factor for breast cancer. And so if we're exposed to cigarette smoke at a younger age, this may be something that's very important to us. Another thing that goes on with adolescent young ladies potentially is having too many x-rays. This is particularly true in young women who have scoliosis, who have needed multiple x-rays while they're being treated for their scoliosis. We do know that's a risk factor. So that naturally then leads me in to the factors that the IOM has discussed that can be done prospectively by you as a way of decreasing your risk of breast cancer. And these include avoiding ionizing radiation. A good example of this is from CAT scans. Having too many CAT scans may in fact increase the risk of breast cancer. It does not include the kind of low dose radiation involved with doing mammograms. Another thing to be avoided is the combination estrogen and progesterone hormonal replacement therapies. And fortunately, the use of those combination drugs has been decreasing, and we've seen a fall off in the incidence of breast cancer as a result. Another thing is the concern about increasing weight in those postmenopausal years. In other words, weight gain when you're beyond and menopause and into your postmenopausal years does increase the risk of breast cancer. The more physical activity that you have, then the better the chance of lowering of the risk. So it's an important study. We will provide a link at breastcanceranswers.com for you to link on to reports about this study. I want to personally thank the Susan G. Komen Foundation for the Cure for sponsoring this important study by the IOM. As far as those other factors that I talked about, hairsprays and deodorants and things in plastics, the data is not clear at this time. But think lifelong, think about living a heart-healthy life like I've indicated in the past. Please know that the Komen Foundation and others are going to continue to fund research to look at those specific other environmental factors where the link is not clear at this time. And so as we say, please stay tuned to breastcanceranswers.com as more information becomes available. We'll be sure to share it with you. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.